Ciao ragazzi, I'm here with the SF90 Stradale. So, the SF90 is Scuderia Ferrari 90. That is the amount of years that Ferrari's been racing. And they made this homage to it. And basically, they made this homage to it. And it has twin turbocharged V8, 4-liter, with electric power assistance. So everyone thinks that this is the new LaFerrari, this is a new hypercar. No, this is a production model that's $600,000. You can go buy one of these if you know the right people. It is four-wheel drive. It can go in all-electric mode, unlike the LaFerrari. And when it is in all-electric mode, it's front-wheel drive. So it's the first front-wheel drive Ferrari. I'm sorry, I'm being interrupted by a really loud car over there. But I'm sorry, I'm kind of critical to this because I don't know where this lies in the model line. It's not the LaFerrari. And like, there's never really been a line, like a middle line for like a mid-engine supercar. It's always like the, let's say the 488 and then a LaFerrari. And now it's like the F8 Tributo, which is kind of a weird car. And then there's this, and then there's LaFerrari. That's like the new LaFerrari that's coming out. I don't understand it. I'm gonna drive it and take back everything I said. But like, right now, the design's like, it's kind of working on me. I mean, like, let's kind of walk to the back here. I forgot to mention, the interior is all new. All new screens, it's phenomenal. Like, go check out my Instagram page and you will see everything you need to know about it. But, I mean, it's about time. Ferrari's had the same interior on its mid-engine supercars since like 2008 when the 458 came out. But the rear, people don't like it. I think it's kind of cool. Like, it'll grow on you. What I don't like about it is the Cavallino head sticking out. That's a little odd to me. But everything else is great. The engine is also really, 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 really low. When I say really low, I mean only 2 inches lower, but it looks really low. It's really odd. I'll put B-roll in of all of this, but I don't know, what do you guys think? Would you buy one of these? Would you get an SVJ Roadster? Because that is same price, and you get a naturally aspirated V12. Or would you get one of these, which is actually kind of forward thinking and futuristic? I don't know, let me know what you think. I wouldn't get it in yellow, but that's just me. Ciao, ragazzi.